common business questions or FAQs is an important use case for chatbots to be able to handle. Now in this video, I'm going to give you a very quick introduction to the question and answers known as Q&A feature in an Oracle Intelligent Bot. Thanks for watching. My name is Grant Ronald from the Oracle Mobile Platform team. Now in the early videos, you've seen me doing demos of banking bots for transferring money and checking balances. However, there's a different category of interaction you might expect with a user. Sometimes a question is simply that. It's a question. When does your branch open? Or how do I reset a password? It's not initiating a back-end process. It's simply a question looking for an answer. And in many cases, businesses already have these questions and answers documented inside a knowledge base, or maybe even already published on a corporate website, assuming you can find it. So, wouldn't it be great for your bot to answer these questions after all these low-level types of calls which consume valuable staff resources at your call centre? So elevating these questions such that they can be answered quickly and efficiently by a bot is a win-win situation for everybody. So in terms of user input, how's an intent, which we've seen before, different from Q&A? Now for an intent, sentence level meaning is most important since it's the meaning of the sentence as a whole which is important. For example, check my balance and balance my check have different meanings even though words are exactly the same. So for intent resolution, it's the understanding of whole sentences that roots to a specific intent that would typically kick off a transaction in the back-end system such as transferring money or ordering a pizza. For Q&A, on the other hand, it's the individual words themselves that are important, and that's because in a Q&A, you're searching for and returning typical multiple answers based on keywords. So if the user said they can't find their bank card, might be lost, need to reset a password, the bot might return answers about how to report a lost card, as well as answers on resetting your online banking passwords and maybe resetting your card PIN. So the words are keys for searching your knowledge base or FAQs, just like for an online search. So Q&A takes the user input and does a word search across the uploaded Q&A, although it's more than simply just a word search. Now, here's how it works. First of all, it will stem the words, which means words like festival, festive, festivities would all be reduced to the same common stem, meaning they match even though they're different forms of a word that might be being used. Next, the Q&A will ignore stop words. So words that aren't really important in the use case, such as in, on, the, at, will not be matched, which makes sense. Why would you want to match those words? Q&A will also do fuzzy matching. So depending on the word length, one or two character changes would still allow the words to match. And this is helpful in cases such as misspelling or different word spelling, such as between English and American English, such as color, center, or switching an S for a Z. Q&A also allows you to define synonyms and abbreviations. So maybe a health insurance Q&A consistently uses spouse, but we might expect the user to say wife or husband. So we want to be able to match spouse to wife or husband. So assuming you already have a known set of Q&A, how do you load these into your bot? Well, currently all you have to do is export your current set of questions and answers into a spreadsheet, three columns, category, questions and answers. And once you've uploaded your questions and answers, you can then edit them directly in an Oracle Intelligent Bot should you wish to, and then train your bot and you're ready to go. So at runtime, the user will input a phrase. The phrase is then sent to both the intent resolution model and the Q&A search model, which both do their magic in taking that sentence, running it through their models and trying to establish whether it thinks it's an intent or a Q&A. If the bot thinks the request is definitely an intent, then it executes the intent. If it thinks you're definitely asking a Q&A question, it will show the possible answers for that question. And if it thinks your input could be interpreted as valid intent or a Q&A, then it shows the user both options, allowing the user to choose what they want to do, execute the intent, or look up the answers in the Q&A. Now, here's a quick demo. Okay, so let's first of all try an input phrase, and this time we'll do asking what's my balance, and what's my balance resolves to an intent, and we'll return the balance. Now we'll ask another question. When are real-time balances available? Now it happens to be that this could resolve to both balances or an FAQ or a Q&A, and there we can view the Q&A. And the third input we'll put in is, let's ask about store opening times. And for store opening times, this resolves only directly to a Q&A, and we can view the different options of Q&A and choose the one that we want to actually view. Now, having uploaded your Q&A, you need to tell the bot to process user input through both the intent and the Q&A models. And you do this by updating the dialogue flow to register that you now want to handle Q&A. And the good news is, this is really simple. You just have to add a new property called Q&A enabled, set to true, to the system.intent. And this ensures that user input is routed to the Q&A model as well as the intent model. And as you can see, there are different properties you can set in order to change the labels that are displayed. So what happens if the system.intent thinks it's found a Q&A match? Well, you have a new action called Q&A, which references a state where you can handle if the input is resolved to a Q&A. And this state uses the new system.Q&A component to handle what gets rendered to the user. And again, you also have the ability to fine tune any labels that get displayed and where the state transitions to next. And that's pretty much it, the basics of the Q&A feature in Oracle Intelligent Bot. Stay tuned for more videos that go into much more detail.